altfel cizme.
What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the Cheeseman Report. I'm your host, Danny Flores. If you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button, that little bell right next to it. That way you get notified every time I upload a new video. Also, don't forget to like and comment down below. Guys, what's good? Welcome back to our brand new Cheeseman Report. Today's report is actually brought to you by a couple. Some of you guys have been asking me to talk about. I'm going to be talking about Juju and Dez, guys, because over the week, people have been speculating that they've broken up, but we're going to talk about it, guys. Go get your snacks, come back, sit back, and relax. A lot of you guys have been asking me, you know, Danny, what do you think about Juju and Dez? And guys, to be honest, I don't really watch them as much, or I don't even watch them at all, because I do see them on my timeline, and I know some of you guys, most of you guys do watch them. But I feel like with Juju and Dez, there's not really much to talk about. There's no like drama in their lives until this week, guys. So this week, I want to say yesterday or the day before, I know some of you guys might be asking like, oh my God, what happened with Juju and Dez? Like, as you guys see in the title above, did they break up? Well, guys, one of you guys actually sent me some screenshots about allegedly, you know, Juju and Dez breaking up, because I know a lot of you guys have or see these YouTube families or YouTube couples as goals. But guys, not everything you see on the internet is real. But getting into this Cheeseman Report, so why do I think, or why do their fans or subscribers think that they've broken up? I want to say this week, I'm not too sure what day it was, Dez actually archived some pictures of, you know, Juju and her. She actually unfollowed Juju on her Instagram account. But from now, when this is being recorded, the pictures are back up, but she did, or she's still unfollowing Juju from Instagram, which I do find kind of weird, because if you go on Juju's Instagram, he's actually following Dez. So I don't know what's going on. I don't know if this is some sort of tactic for online, because we all know, you know, Juju and Dez do like to do pranks on you guys, on their subscribers.
April Fools. A lot of you guys probably didn't even know it was April Fools, but it is April Fools. Yeah, but it is April Fools.
Or they probably expected one of us to prank each other, but no. We pranked the JD family and the KB and Carla.
But what does this mean? Honestly, I don't know what it means. It could be, you know, like I said, everything you see on the internet, you can't believe it, you can't trust it, because a lot of people are speculating this whole breakup. But guys, in real life, you know, they might have argued, and to the point where, you know, Dez got really mad and unfollowed him and actually archived all their pictures. But we don't know the situation as of right now. You guys don't know Juju and Dez. They recently just had a baby, and guys, once you have a baby, once you have a newborn, it's really hard and frustrating at the same time. So I might have caused some arguments here and there, and you know, like I said, maybe Juju and Dez actually got in an argument. All couples argue, so maybe that's why Dez unfollowed Juju and, you know, archived all the pictures. But we all seen these couples on YouTube going back and forth with each other on Instagram. Doesn't necessarily mean that they're broken up. Maybe they're just having a break, we don't know. But let me know what you guys think about the situation, because I know a lot of you guys do watch Juju and Dez and probably think they're couple goals. But yeah, let me know down below, guys. Now switching up gears, a lot of you guys have been asking me to, you know, talk about true crime. I'm gonna try for the first time, so hey, keep in mind, this is my first time talking about true crime, don't come at me. But yesterday, guys, or the day before, a TikToker by the name of Ollie, actually, you know, his wife, and when I go like this, it doesn't mean, you know, he slashed her or whatever, but he actually shot her, because I don't know what was in this guy's head. But basically, this TikTok star from San Diego, you know, had a very big following, and he had a lot of videos on TikTok with his wife. And guys, I'm gonna be honest with you, I always tell you, what you see on the internet, you can't have those expectations, because the internet is very, I want to say, like, sometimes it's not true. And when you see people happy dancing or whatever, it's just for that moment, or it could be just for that video. But it didn't seem that way, guys, because Anna Marie was actually asking for a divorce, and she actually kicked out Ali from the apartment. Before Ali left, he actually, you know, made a copy of their key, that way he could go back inside or whatever, do whatever he wants. So he left, and like I said, he had the copy of the key. He actually came back to the apartment, destroyed the whole apartment, and actually downloaded downloaded an app on his, I want to say his daughter's iPad or a listening device, where he was able to listen in conversations, what goes down in that, you know, in their apartment. So he did that. He goes back to the hotel room and, you know, he's basically listening on his phone, seeing like what's good, what's popping. And Anna Marie actually had a friend there. She had a friend come over, and that's when things got tough. That's when things went off the rails. So Ali heard a man's voice and he actually left the hotel, ran to the apartment, and that's when he shot both of them and killed them, guys. Once he does that, he runs out, you know, runs out of the apartment. He calls his mom and confesses everything to her, saying, you know what, this was what happened, I did this. And guys, I don't know what was going on through Ali's head. Like, this guy had everything. He had the followers. He had, you know, the social media. He was popping, I guess. But, you know, followers, money, I guess, can't buy you happiness. And this, that. And that's what he did, guys. He went rage. He did that to his wife and her friend. Then with the loaded gun, he goes, picks up his daughter at school, and that's when he goes on the freeway. I believe it was the 805 in San Diego, and the cops actually arrested him there. He was on the side of the freeway. I don't know what he was gonna do, but he did have a court yesterday, and he pleaded not guilty to all these charges, which I was like, what the hell? Like, you literally confessed to your mom and you're over here pleading not guilty in front of a judge. Like, you know how. Never mind. But guys, the creepiest thing was that day when he, you know, did this whole murder scene on his apartment, he actually uploaded a video on Facebook. I don't think I have the video, but I do have a screenshot of him, you know, dressed up as, you know, John Wick. And if you guys haven't seen John Wick, I mean, that's a great movie. But John Wick in the movie, he's a assassin. Like, he kills for a living. For him to upload that story or that video few hours before he does that, like, that's creepy, that's weird. But guys, this is an ongoing investigation. That's all I have for you guys today with this whole true crime. If you guys want to hear more, if you guys liked how I spilled the tea, how I spilled the true crimes tea, let me know down in the comments below, because I'm more than willing to film these, because I honestly love true crime. I listen to Crime Junkie on Apple Podcasts, which, you know, they're freaking good at telling true crime. So maybe I could be telling you guys what I like, the stories I like, or the, you know, conspiracy theories that go on with true crime. But yeah, let me know down below, guys. But this is gonna be the end of the Chisme Report. Hopefully you guys did enjoy it, and let me know how I did, guys, because it's my first time. Thank you guys so much. My name's Danny, and I'm out. Peace.